Welcome to the Knife Junkie Podcast, your weekly dose of knife news and information about knives and knife collecting. Here's your hosts, Jim Person and Bob the Knife Junkie DeMarco.
Welcome to the Knife Junkie Podcast. I'm Jim Person.
And I'm Bob DeMarco from TheKnifeJunkie.com.
Great show planned for you today. We've got a couple of segments. We're going to have our maintenance minute where Bob the Knife Junkie is going to be talking about stropping. We also have a Knife Life news segment when we've got a product review of the Snaggletooth.
The Snaggletooth MF.
Looking forward to hearing what that one's about. But, of course, we always start our show with the pocket check.
Yeah.
And I've got my Swiss Army knife. Yep. Love the toothpick part of it.
You know, Jim, you can buy 5 packs of those toothpicks on Amazon.
Oh, okay.
I just found that out because
nice.
I found an old Victorinox in a guitar case. My brother gave me a guitar gifted me unwittingly a Victorinox, and I thought, I'm going to use this, sharpen it up, I'm not using that toothpick.
No.
Because I know that's his favorite.
Well, speaking of Amazon, if you find the content we provide on TheKnifeJunkie.com and the podcast and the YouTube and all that kind of stuff valuable, and you're looking for a new knife, want to go to Amazon.TheKnifeJunkie.com and shop there. We do get a small commission, but it's not going to increase the price you pay, and it does show some love for the show, so we do appreciate that. But, Bob, what do you got in your pocket?
So today, my main carry in my front right pocket is the Protec Rockeye. Mm-hmm. It's an automatic, my only high-quality automatic knife, a.k.a. Switchblade.
Well, you know, the holidays are coming. Sounds like you might need another one.
Oh, you know?
Yeah, put it on your list.
It's a part of my collection that has a big gaping hole. So here in my left pocket, where I ordinarily keep a slip joint today, I'm rocking my little bug out. I love this Benchmade bug out. Yeah. It's so light.
I like the color too, blue.
Yeah, it's
my favorite color. Right? Yeah, I like it. Yeah, it might be
happy little.
Might
fella.
Be one on my list.
Yeah, Christmas is coming, Jim.
That's right. I've seen this one before.
It's the Broken Skull.
Yeah,
but that is the Snaggletooth.
Okay.
So, I have it on my Broken Skull, and it helps me open it efficiently.
And we're going to be talking about that, and you have a little review of that coming up shortly.
That's right.
So, what is it about that knife you like carrying all the time?
Well, it's a 4-inch blade. I prefer folding knives with 4-inch blades. It's a clip point. It's super duper thin and light, but that steel, this is CTX XHP steel, which is a really, really great steel, especially for the amount of money you pay for it. So I always say there's no excuse to not have 4 inches of razor sharp super steel in your pocket because it's so damn small and thin.
Right.
So.
All right. Cool. So different types of blades, blade shapes, utilities, that's kind of what we're going to be talking about today?
Well, yeah, as you can see, these 3 knives I'm carrying on me today, they all look similar but different. I mean, they're all very close to one another, but they have different blade shapes for different purposes, and that's what we're going to talk about today.
Bob and Jim will have more of the Knife Junkie Podcast in just a minute, but now here's this week's Maintenance Minute.
Stropping is an easy and gratifying way to keep your knives sharp without sharpening them. Let me mansplain. When I use the word sharpen, I'm referring to a process that removes metal from the edge of a blade, making it sharper, with abrasives, like stone, diamond stone, or ceramic. Stropping, on the other hand, will restore an edge, as long as it's not too far gone, without removing metal, and without the use of high-grit abrasives. Think of the edge of a blade like a micro saw. It's got all of these small micro serrations that allow it to cut. Now think of that micro saw blade after a day of cutting cardboard, paracord, and blister packages. The cutting micro serrations are now out of true, some jutting off in one direction and some jutting off in the other. Now take that micro saw and drag it, edge trailing, down a stretch of leather. Now flip the blade and drag the other side of the micro saw in a similar fashion. Repeat this a few times and watch the micro serrations realign into a proper micro saw, and check out the polish that's quickly forming on your edge. This is where I double back to say stropping can be done without abrasives, but it is much more effective when you use just a little, in the form of stropping compound. There are stropping compounds manufactured for this very purpose in varying grits that you apply to your leather strop. But before I discovered these specialized compounds, I would use aluminum polish rubbed into the leather strop surface, and with a little bit more elbow grease, it worked great. These compounds further polish the edge by removing infinitesimal amounts of metal and reducing the scale of the micro saw, taking it to next level sharpness. Stropping is a great way to maintain your blade's edge on a regular basis. If you hard use your knives every day, run it over the strop 10 times every night before the blade gets too dull and necessitates a thorough sharpening. I have one strop that I received from USA-made blade and that one I love. But I also have three more that I have made from pieces of unfinished belt glued to 7-inch lengths of yardstick. So don't let cost be an issue. Make a strop, start using it regularly, and see if you notice a difference in your daily cutting performance.
That's this week's Maintenance Minute, and now more of the Knife Junkie Podcast.
All right, back on the Knife Junkie Podcast. Bob, I got to tell you, I really enjoyed that segment there with the stropping. I never knew that, and then your tip about just using an old belt.
Jim, stropping cool. was an absolute revelation to me, and I was exposed to it through various YouTubers over the years, and it has really made a difference. The less metal you have to remove, the better. And plus, there's something contemplative and, I don't know, enjoyable
right,
about the zen-like process.
You know, I've got an old belt. I've actually lost some weight, so maybe that'll become my stropping belt instead
of
throwing it away. All right, so blade shapes and their utilities. That's kind of what we're talking about today, kind of continuing our Knife 101 series, if we will. So shapes and utilities, kind of what's our main point you want to talk about?
Well, regardless of size or application, or regardless of what knife you see it in, there are certain ubiquitous blade shapes, and they were all evolved to fill certain roles and to do certain tasks, optimized for certain tasks.
Okay.
All right. That's what you find in the design of any kind of thing.
Sure, sure.
The knife shapes have subtle differences, and then some of them have radical differences. But,
okay.
But I guess we'll start with a drop point. Simple drop point.
Okay.
This is a knife-shaped knife.
Right. Yeah.
This happens to be a Topps Tex Creek. It's a knife I use all the time. A drop point means the spine of the blade drops down to the tip. This is a very subtle drop on this blade.
It's not straight. Okay. It has a little bit of an angle, I guess, to it.
Right. Which puts the point a little bit lower than the spine.
Okay.
And these are generally used for multi-purpose, all-purpose knives. You see this a lot on camp knives. Even if you look at your kitchen knives, many of them are drop points, technically. But to me, they are the most generic of knife shape and the most utilitarian in their sense of multi-purpose.
Mm-hmm. So